Okay, this is a quick video on how to goal seek, but we have to do a little bit of review first. First, we're given a function, f of x equals the square root of x minus 5. X is my input, and if I know what x is, I'll be able to find my output. And number 1 says find f of 27. Get rid of that. And number 2 says find x if f of x equals 10. All right, so to start, you want to put the function in. You always use an equal sign, and square root is sqrt, and then you click on the cell where the x's are, minus 5. Okay, and so now your formula is in, and it says hashtag number. That means that 0 is not in the domain, and so we don't want to put any numbers that are not in the domain. And we, if you remember from previous math classes, what's under a radical has to be greater than or equal to 0. So I can start at 5, and then I'm all the x values from here on out after 5 will be in the domain. Okay, so now we're ready to answer question 1. I call this an input find the output problem. So I'm given the input is 27, so I'm just going to drag this down once and put 27 in. And by the way, a lot of people think sometimes you need to get this data then do a trend line. That's a concept error. You're given the function that I want you to use. There's no need to find a function if you know what the function is. So don't do that. Don't do a trend line if you're given a function. You only do a trend line when you're just given data. All right, so the answer to number 1 is 4.69. Okay, now the next one is when we need goal seek, because we're looking for the input if we know the output. And we just can't put 10 in here. If we put 10 in here, we'll lose the formula. The formula went away. So that's why we need goal seek. So I'm going to undo that. So when you're given the output and you want to find the input, let's drag this down so we don't lose our previous answer. And we're just going to click on this f of x, and we can't type 10 in, but what we're going to do is type in data, click on data, what if analysis, goal seek. And then we have this dialog box that says set cell, and it says B9 because that's what I clicked on first. And we want to change that B9 to 10, but we don't want to lose the formula, so this is the way we're going to do it. And then by changing cell, well, we want to change this x value. And so when I hit OK, Excel is going to start looking and looking and looking and looking until it finds the correct x value. And it did it. So and now it says 9.9945, that's close enough, but I will say one more thing that's relatively new discovery of mine. If you want to get an more exact answer, you can go to File, Options, and then Formulas, and this where it says Maximum Change, just type in a really, really small number with lots of zeros and end it at 1. And let's see what happens this time. So I'll just compare. So now if I want to goal seek, we can practice one more time. I'm going to click on the y value that I want to change to 10, go to data, what if analysis, goal seek, change the value to 10, and say XL, hey, look for the value of x that's going to make that happen. And you can see how much more accurate it is. So that's how you goal seek. X is 105.